बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलामुअलैकुम। उम्मीद है आप सब लोग खैरियत से होंगे। अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह, मैं भी बिल्कुल खैरियत से हूँ। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर लेक्चर नंबर 26, विच वुड बी द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड प्रीवियसली रिगार्डिंग द डेफिनेशंस ऑफ पब्लिक पॉलिसी, रिगार्डिंग द प्रोसेस ऑफ पब्लिक पॉलिसी, रिगार्डिंग द एनालिसिस ऑफ पब्लिक पॉलिसी, and on the basis of those three main aspects regarding public policy, we are now going to come up with this particular lecture number 26, in which we would be seeing the combination of the theoretical principles of the public policy, and we would also have been discussing few of the examples of the applications of those public policy on community level basis. Even we would have been studying the community cycle from the public policy point of view, and in our today's lecture we will be trying to have the combination of some of the theoretical aspect and some of the application of all those theories. So dear students, from that particular point of view, I would have been discussing with you all in our today's lecture the public health model 2 from the application side of the theories of public policy. So for that, we will start about this public policy health model, particularly from the point of view of the combination or the mixture of the theoretical aspect and the practical aspect of the theories of public policy. And here we would have been starting like that from public health model point of view. We have to start with this: who are you? Then who am I? Your introduction. Why are we here? For which purpose you would have been gathering together in that particular aspect. We will be starting this public health model from public policy point of view from the type of housekeeping. And this housekeeping would have been discussing with you the aspect of agenda, and then aspect of group agreements, then even about the parking lot, and then from practical point of view the expectations which would have been associated with that particular practical aspect of the public policy theories, and then even the restrooms and the breaks which you would have been have to do during that particular sessions. Dear students, as far as the objectives of this particular exercise is concerned, it will actually help you understand in the form of the explain the basic health model and environmental prevention. In our today's session, which is on the side of the practical aspect of the public policy related issues, and it is meant for the objective of providing you with an insight about the public health model. In our upcoming lectures, I will even providing you with an insight of environmental related formulation of the policies, application of those policies which would primarily be focusing on environmental issues. Then in inshallah our upcoming lectures, I would even would have been providing you the comparison of educational, health and environmental policies from 6 countries perspective, that how in different countries these policies are formulated and then implemented. And in our final lectures, even I would have been providing you with the insights into the economic policy perspective of Pakistan and all that. The objectives of our today's session is to explain you the public health model and environmental prevention, देन एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कनेक्शन बिटवीन पॉलिसीज एंड नॉर्म्स एंड इट्स इम्प्लीकेशन फॉर सोशल चेंज एंड देन वी वुड हैव बीन गोइंग फॉर द आइडेंटिफिकेशन एंड टू डिस्क्राइब अवेलेबल प्रिवेंशन स्ट्रेटजीज देन वर्क विद द टूल्स फॉर कम्युनिटी असेसमेंट एंड प्लानिंग एंड देन टू डिस्कस different ways you can advocate for policy change even and guidelines to follow for that matter and outline key issues in monitoring and enforcement from the public policy health model point of view. So dear students, in module 1 we would have been discussing about the public policy landscape from the health model point of view. And this of our public policy landscape would have been including a discussion on public health model, environmental prevention, some history regarding environmental prevention and public health model. Then we would also have been having some discussion on the norms and the policies of these areas. And even we would have been discussing the reactive and proactive approaches here as far as the policy perspective is concerned. So dear students, for public health model, from public policy point of view, the most important aspects are shown to you in this particular slide. Public health model would have been bringing into consideration the aspect of environment, and the host and the agent and how they would have been playing their role. This is what which we will have been discussing in our upcoming slides. Dear students, what which is very important for all of us to understand is that every one of us is different. Particularly from health perspective, we have to show serious agreement and concrete agreement on this aspect that everybody is different. One has a use problem, two or three abstain, and then six use socially, and it will have been bringing you to reach at the individual focused prevention strategies. And these individual focused prevention strategies would be intervention for one, and then this intervention for one would have been taking you to the perspective of the involving everybody separately into it, which will finally be taking you towards the understanding of the environmental prevention, which has been shown to you in this particular slide. Managing settings and locations from environmental prevention point of view, and then where use and sales occur from that particular point of view. Dear students, this particular aspect will have been finally taking you towards the excise taxes about the usage of tobacco from environmental pollution point of view. And then even risks to smoking were well known even by 1964. On the basis of that, a smoke-free area concept was come into picture, which receives highest amount of attraction and attention. And this brings major changes in smokers' behavior, which appears and occurs in the 1990s actually. Now, dear students, on the basis of environmental perspective, evolution of smoking ban occurs frequently in different countries from the community perspective, and the number of municipalities or countries in California with mandated smoke-free workplaces. Initially, it happened in 1990 for 8 perspective, then in 1990 for the second go, even 11 entered into that. In their third approach, in their third strike, then in 1991, 12 entered into the picture. In 13, 1993 again, It hit the 12 perspective, and in 1994, 12 from 53 particular point of view. Dear students, this evolution continued on worldwide basis, and even in 1994, statewide workplace smoking got banned initially. Then in 1998, smoking was declared banned even in bars. In 2007, in Los Angeles, smoking was banned even in public parks as a policy decision. And then even in 2008, smoking in moving vehicles in the presence of a minor or young children was also banned by the application of the policy. Dear students, now this public policy aspect of making smoking ban in different states of United States of America could be related to the overall public health model policy. It was one aspect of that, because as far as health issue is concerned, smoking is injurious to health. Everyone knows that, everyone believes in that, and this has served actually the basic foundation for the development of the policy regarding public health model. And as far as particular aspect of norm is concerned, it has even taken the shape of a norm. And what is a norm? Standard or model developed by individuals or groups as far as behavior is concerned. And even we could take it as the shared beliefs, usually unwritten, about acceptable behavior in different societies. Then volunteer ways of behaving in expected manner within a certain group. These are the different aspects of the understanding of the definition of norm, and the way government has banned smoking in public areas, in parks, in bars, even in moving vehicles in the presence of young children and all that, is going to be serve as the basic foundation into the creation of the policy regarding public health model. So, dear students, for the development of this public health model on policy level, you have to also understand the community wheel, how community would be receiving benefits of this particular policy. As far as the community wheel is concerned, dear students, it remains in the form of our understanding, as it actually covers many aspects of it. For example, in the community wheel, media is always there playing its role. Then at grassroots level, there are different beliefs and norms which would be letting something happens in that particular community, or otherwise it serves as a very big blockage towards the acceptance of something in that community. Then in that community wheel, neighborhood associations used to play a very important role, and in the neighborhood association, the impact of their health care providers would be entering into picture as far as their significance onto the development of policy of public health is concerned. Then faith community would always remain in the community cycle. Then in one community cycle, there are always law enforcement agencies, there are different educational level standards which different individual would have been earning, and on the basis of that education, they would have been developing certain behaviors. Then civic volunteers are there. Then human and socially oriented organization and services are there. Then recreation and parks are there. Then governments are there. Then business are there. In one community, they all different aspects make their presence felt, and on the basis of this community wheel. So now what are policies? General principles by which an entity, And that entity could be a company, could be a city, could be a country, or could be a state, is guided. And then the bridge between customs and laws could also serve as the terminology of policy. The formal acknowledgement of the customs of a society could also be taken as the policy of that particular area. So, dear students, policies could be formal in the form of written documents, as I might told you this something before too, and policies could also be informal in different communities in the form of unwritten rules. Dear students, as far as the 10 commandments are concerned, from the public health policy model point of view, or from the point of view of the role of policies and norms into the development of any policy, whether health related, environment related, or education related, it would have been playing its very, very significant and influential role into the formulation of policies. And those policies would actually be making you develop reactive or proactive approach. Changing norms lead to changes in public policy. It means if on the basis of over the years period of time, public behavior, the norms of the society, the values of the society, if they would have been continuously changing, it would be making the policy be also changed for that community. And changing policies also impact social norms. It is actually be a two-way direction oriented drive. With the change in the norms, policies must also be changed, and with the changes in the policy, these changed policy also impacts the norms of that society. Now, as far as the spectrum of prevention from that public health model point of view is concerned, one very important something has been shown here, that it would be influencing policy and legislations. Then it would be definitely felt into the changing organizational practices. Then it would be there in the fostering coalitions and networks. And then it would be there felt significantly in the educating provider scenario. And then promoting community education would again be given into the spectrum of prevention. And then strengthening individual knowledge and skills would also be entering into the spectrum of prevention, dear students. Now, if we want to develop the worksheet of the spectrum of prevention, it would be making you understand the influencing policy and legislation, and changing institutional practices, and fostering coalitions and networks. Then the people who are among the members of education providers, then promoting community education, and finally, strengthening individual knowledge, and on the basis of that knowledge, the skill pool of an individual. Dear students, what we were discussing before, from the public health model policy point of view, we have taken environment as one very important aspect of it, and from environmental prevention point of view, policy would be related to the taking into your serious consideration again the aspect of environment and the host and the agent for your long-term goals to be achieved. Dear students, policy and environmental change, as far as the rationale of this aspect is concerned, beyond brochures, it would have been actually letting you know about different actions which would be based and formulated on the basis of policy focus actually. For example, in activity programs focus, we have to discuss about on-time aspect. From policy focus point of view, it must be an ongoing activity. intended to learn behavior change and it would be driven from the intention to change the behavior. Then limited duration would be actually intended and derived from the long-term aspect. Then non-sustainability would actually be making you from the policy focus point of view to come up with the sustainable policies and all that. And on the same line, if we talk about different issues and on the basis of those issues, which activities or programs would have been designed from among the available policy options, few more something are given here, which I will be discussing with you all, particularly from the employee health and productivity point of view. If we take it as an issue of an organization and if you have to formulate the policy regarding the employee health and productivity, then wellness fair must be appearing as your main activity or program, and policy option would obviously be available to you in the form of agency minimum nutritional standard. It would be making you think about the changed behavior. Then you have to talk about the reach aspect from the policy point of view. Cost would be there obviously to do all these things. And the most important aspect regarding this employee health and productivity policy would be the sustainability and maintainability of that policy. Dear students, after that module 1, if we talk about now regarding module 2, it would be letting you know how to select the right policy, because this is what we have discussed before, that there would be the alternative policies available to you, and on the basis of the availability of those alternative policies, it was suggested to you before that you have to go for the evaluation of all those policies, and that evaluation would have been making you choose the right policy. What other aspects actually are relevant to selecting the right policy is to collect the data regarding that particular issue, then rest. Then 4 P's which are available to you, which we will be discussing in coming slides, and then prevention strategies would also be very, very significant from this point of view. And obviously all these policies are meant for the community, so community planning will also be entering into the picture in this module 2, dear students. Now apply data and research. It would have been making you know the problem well. The first step, the first very concrete foundation step for the formulation of the policy, particularly any public policy, and here in the case of public health model, you are required to know the actual problem well, and this applied data and research will be helping you know the problems well. And how will actually it happen? Through the archival data, through the key informant interviews, through the different surveys and polls, and through the observations, and through ASIPS and GIS. Dear students, data is essential. Data is essential to know your problem well. It is actually be the starting point towards that. Data defines the magnitude of the problem actually. How big is the problem? How about the severity or intensity of the problem, in other words? And good data guides intervention planning. And information systems demonstrates your outcomes. To refine the work, you again need to have the data. To identify intermediate outcomes, it would be heavily relying upon the available data, dear students, and celebrate success. It is going to be the fruitful results which you would have been consuming on the basis of the availability of the accurate and updated data. Dear students, it will be helping you be aware of which policy you have to take up and at which level. Which policies can actually change the environment and reduce the risk? It would be related to the issue of your home, your neighborhood, your institutional perspective, the concept and the consideration of your city or state or even at national level. Dear students, now as far as on the basis of this assessment, strategic choices which would be available to you are given in the name of mandatory and voluntarily and step by step process of going for your strategic choices. Dear students, what make good policy, the excellent policy? Number one, something which is winnable. Number two, which is actually real and which is immediate as far as its application and doability is concerned, which would be specific, by specific. I actually want you all to understand this aspect, that for which particular target this policy has been designed and implemented, for which particular issue, for which particular problem, for which particular program or project. Specificity means that this policy has been formulated, then it must be tangible, doable. Policy should be clearly linked to the feasible and appropriate goals. Given by McKinney Themba, this is what I was telling you just a moment before, that specificity and measurability, actually those characteristics which links to the specific goals which you really would like to achieve through the formulation and the implementation of your policy, dear students. And now we have discussed one characteristics of feasibility of the policy. What do we mean by that? What is actually feasible? What is the political climate, current trends? You would have to ask yourself the question to find out the feasible answer and policy which must be suiting that political climate and the current trends. And for making something feasible, you have to ask yourself another question, that what is the level of stakeholder support if I have to come up with this particular policy, or if otherwise I would have been taking up some other choice, whether I will be able to collect and earn the political support and the support from the stakeholders. If yes, it means that policy would be highly feasible. And other question which would be making those choices feasible are related to how strong and organized is the opposition. Then another question, how will the policy be implemented and enforced? Very, very important aspect, dear students. The way you would have to finally implement it, and you have to go for the enforcement of that. How will its effect be monitored and measured? Ki iske efforts kis tarah monitor karenge aap, kis tarah measure karenge? Agar aapke paas iske doable options available hai, to iska matlab hai ki aapki policy ek doable ya feasible policy hai. What unintended consequences might there be, and if you can predict those unintended consequences, if you can develop some intuitive judgment about that, and even if you could come up with the proactive approach of finding out the remedy of that, it will be making that policy feasible, dear students. Now, if we go further with this discussion, as far as now policies and civil liberties are concerned, civil liberties would also be playing their significant role into the formulation and implementation of policies. Dear students, from civil liberties point of view, you have to bring into your understanding the aspect of taxation, then restrictions on advertising, then community policing, then sovereignty checkpoints, then restrictions in retail availability. These are going to be the civil liberties whom you have to pay some respect in your policy formulation, which has further to be implemented. Now, focused policy choice. What would be your focused policy choice? Decide on goals that meet the risk test. And what is that risk test? Select strategies and activities to help meet your goals. All very simple, dear students. You have to develop realistic, achievable, measurable, time-bound goals to be successful in your that effort actually. Then evaluate and evaluate and then re-evaluate for your next cycle of the policy implementation. Now, if we talk about the underlying principles from that particular environmental prevention point of view and the four P's of our marketing point of view, the first P is regarding the pricing here. The second P is about the product placing and the promotion. These four P's would have to strictly remain within the environmental prevention limits as far as your policy is concerned. Now, regarding that, we have to discuss a case to make ourselves understand the policy aspect well. And case in point has been given here in the form of the problem. The problem is this: a residential urban area near a major California university is plagued by public intoxication and related problems. So availability of cheap alcohol products perceived to be an instigating factor for that particular problem. And now, with the same case in point, we would have been continuing our study regarding the development of strategies and the outcomes on the basis of those four P's. And as far as the place, product, price and promotion is concerned here, from place point of view, as far as the strategies which could become available to you are surveyed local retailers to assess the availability and held press conferences in front of problem business. Then the outcomes of that of your this strategy would be the availability of alcohols in local store must be reduced on volunteer basis. Then press conferences must be creating strong media presence that gave coalition some leverage. Now, from product point of view, entire strategy would be focusing on particular beverages, and the outcome of that would be given in the form here, that city task force to study the issue of alcohol beverage formed actually. Then, from price point of view, dear students, the strategies would be actively supported and proposed state legislation to tax alcohol as distilled spirits rather than as beer or wine. And it would have been giving you the outcome of city takes leadership role in statewide effort. Now, as far as the issue regarding promotional policy is concerned, it would have been providing you with the strategies of ask the retailers to voluntarily remove from the store advertising, and it will have been giving you the outcome of partial compliance. Advertising was reduced voluntarily. So, dear students, prevention strategies are actually be the most important strategies from public health model point of view. Prevention is always better than cure. This is a common statement which we heard on many occasions, and here it has been reinforced again that there is no need to reinvent the wheel. Everybody agrees that prevention strategies would be even most effective strategies regarding that. So, dear students, from prevention strategies point of view, what could we do regarding this public health model at policy level is to go for zoning and land use ordinances must be enforced. Then the responsible beverages service training must be there. Then it must be addressing the social host policies. Then it must be discussing the nuisance abatement. So regarding prevention strategies, it is already be said clearly that no need to reinvent the wheel. And the prevention strategies, my dear students, must be bringing those few things into their important consideration as far as the zoning and land use ordinances are concerned. It must be addressing the responsible beverage service training too. Then the social host policies must be considered seriously in this perspective. The nuisance abatement would again be playing its vital role here. And then deemed approved ordinances should also be discussed from the prevention strategies point of view. Then crime-free multi-housing training must be given in this particular aspect. Now, if we talk about the module 3 of getting policy adopted, okay, you have formulated it before, but as far as the adoption aspect of this policy is concerned, here in this particular slide, in our upcoming few more slides, dear students, we would have been discussing this adoption aspect of the policy. It would be based on community organizing. Then there ought to be a law for this particular aspect, and then there must be media advocacy should remain available to you as your backup support, and then you need to get yourself involved into going for the consultation to the policy makers in the form of talking to policy makers. Then non-profit advocacy must be there, and developing advocacy skills would be helping you as far as the adaptation in module 3 of the policy is concerned. Dear students, from that particular point of adoption, we have to discuss the importance of community organizing, because the whole principles and the theories and the process and the analysis of public policy is initially and finally meant for the individuals and for the communities who represent different individuals living in that community. And the first aspect of that is to develop constituency for change. Constituency, I told you that aspect before, where different people would have been living together and would have been consuming different services provided to them by the government. And it will be making the aspect of build support for the policies in that community. That build support for the policies in the community will be making you organize different parts of the community to play a strategic role. Few of the people who must be the senior citizens, who must be even the members of the reference group of that society, must involve into this aspect to add weight into whatever you really would like to do for the adoption perspective of your policy. And then it will automatically making you come up with the perspective of the development of leadership and the sustainability from the point of view of the adoption of the policy. Dear students, now as far as the last aspect of the leadership development is concerned, from policy adoption point of view, it will make you think about the legitimacy of that particular aspect, the visibility of the whatever has been involved into that, and the scope of influence, and finally the group cohesiveness would also be entering into the picture as far as community-based leadership development would be concerned as a product of public policy health model particularly concerned. Now steps in the community organizing process have been given. The first step is related to the assessment, and this assessment is all about knowing the community and its issues. It means कि आप अपनी community के बारे में अच्छी तरह तमाम मालूमात आपके पास है, आपको इस बारे में एक complete information है कि आपकी community के related issues क्या क्या है. This assessment will have been making you go for the coalition building. And in this coalition building, after the assessment, you have to invite people to join together to initiate the change. कोएलेशन का मतलब आप यहाँ पे ये ले सकते हैं डियर स्टूडेंट्स कि आपने अपनी कम्युनिटी में ग्रुप फॉर्मुलेशन करनी है, आपने अपने साथ लोगों की आवाज मिलानी है फॉर द अटेनमेंट ऑफ द डिजायर्ड ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड इट विल हैव बीन टेकिंग यू टू द नेक्स्ट स्टेज ऑफ दैट व्हिच इज ऑल अबाउट द मोबिलाइजेशन एंड द एक्शन. In mobilization and action step of the community organizing process, you have to engage the whole community or the representative of community in that particular issue and to help them come up with the facilitation's action. Then you have to go for the planning perspective of community organizing process, and the planning perspective of this community organizing process would be addressing the issue of select the real issues the community can change at that particular point in time as a result of your total effort. Dear students, then the community wheel which we have discussed before again would have been representing few of the significant features or the characteristics of it. In community wheel, we have to bring into our consideration the schools which would have been providing education to the students. Then along with those schools, in community wheel, you have to bring into your serious respect and caring attitude as far as the senior citizens are concerned. There would be different service organizations in the community. There would be different partners organization in the community. Then there is another important aspect of the community wheel of the social services whichever is available there, and then there would be law enforcement agencies, and then government representation in the form of political actors or government representative would be there into that community wheel. Business organization usually plays a very significant and strong role in one community's overall norms and behaviors and culture and all that. Then the religious values are always there which represents a community. Then the medical facilities which would be available to that community actually remains in place as far as this community wheel is concerned. Youth and media, they both are going to be the one pillar of the overall community wheel. You cannot ignore the importance of the youth of that community. At the same time, one could not underestimate the value of the media in one community, particularly from the policy development, policy formulation, and quite sensitively and quite significantly as far as the adoption of one policy is concerned. You know, dear students, in this module 3, our prime concern is about the module 3. In module 3, our prime concern is about the adoption of the policy. And into the adoption of policy, media usually play very, very important and sensitive role. Dear students, this community wheel now would let us about the rules to live by. Know and communicate facts clearly and accurately as far as living in a community is concerned. It must make you learn the rules of the policy sandbox you will be playing in actually, and know your allies, work in a coordinated and collective and interdependent fashion, know your opposition, and even talk about the celebrate you who would have been performing their significant role in this adoption of the policy. Dear students, along with that, the next aspect which you will have to talk about is there ought to be a law. And if there is a law, and often there remains law in different communities, it will be actually benefiting your overall adoption of the policy, that new policy is always usually based on existing laws or regulations. There would be very lesser chances that any new policy would not be emerging or would not be the result of some existing law or the regulation through which that community has been governed. Another aspect regarding the there ought to be law is the importance of educating the policy maker, training the trainers aspect. You even have to educate the policy makers that these are the issues of this particular community, these are the ways how to design and how to formulate and implement policy related to one community, and then they must be advocating policy change with key stakeholders and organizations, dear students. This is how and this is why the existence of law must be there. Now, as far as media advocacy is there, I was telling you this something before, that from adoption point of view, the media support and media advocacy would be playing very, very important role. And from media advocacy point of view, dear students, it is about framing the access in setting the agenda actually. Now, framing the content and then shaping the debate, then advancing the policy, which would be influencing the policy makers, are all aspects of media advocacy. For example, here in this particular advertisement, or if it would have been going into the media for its promotion, it must have been going through the perspective of media advocacy too, along with its promotional aspect. Now, how to make a news for the community, for the public and media advocacy, and particularly from the health model point of view, as far as the policy in perspective of community cycle and community wheels is concerned. How to make news? Hold media events. If you would be holding media events, it will always be providing you with the news. Then create your own media using social media outlets such as Twitter is available to you, Facebook, YouTube, many other alternative options would be available to you. And then submit guest editorials and comment on news outlet, blogs and stories electronically. It will be helping you come up with the news, and then write letters to the editors. And then you are required to go for the solicitors, columnist or features. And even you are required to organize media ride-alongs. Dear students, have you have the tools regarding this media advocacy and the development of a news? Then it must be coming up with the compelling message, having the backup of data, then authentic voices must be given there, then policy goals and policy decisions must be given in that, and then time and place for those opportunities would be an important aspect of it. Now, how to talk to a policy makers? Before a few slides, I was letting you be aware of this important theoretical prospect that you have to consult the policy maker as a community representative particularly from the adoption module 3 point of view, and how to talk to a policy maker in some community. There are few ways and approaches available to us. Initially, you are required to earn and win an appointment, then don't be awed, then know your facts, what you have to talk about to the policy makers, then make your pitch in 5 to 15 minutes, don't exceed it more than 15 minutes, and then listen the responses of the policy maker very carefully. And then, dear students, do not let him or her evade the issue. And then you are also advised to use all questions as your opportunities. This is somehow very, very important aspect. And you must use the praise and the respect in your communication and press for the commitment to the policymakers and build relationship with the staff of the policymakers' office. Dear students, along with that, there is another aspect of non-profit advocacy. What it is all about? It is all about that non-profits and charities can do only limited lobbying. Then the amount of lobbying depends upon IRS classification. Small organization, particularly which would be spending less than $500,000 a year, can expand up to 20% on the lobbying aspect. Then advocating candidates for appointed post is again permitted in that non-profit advocacy. Dear students, what is actually lobbying, and now what is not lobbying? Advocacy by unpaid volunteers is not lobbying. Non-partisan analysis or study or research would be the part of your not lobbying, and then examination of broad social problems would again be free from this lobbying, or in other words, must not be lobbying. And then Alliance for Justice, for whom I have quoted here a website too, must be again not lobbying. Dear students, after that module 3 of adoption, now if we talk about the module 4 of enforcement, monitoring, and the sustainability of your policy, it is not about police work. Remember this. In communities, you don't have to always behave like a police officer. You have to actually win the intentions for the adoption of that policies. You have to come up with the willingness of the acceptance of that policy in spite of all the time going for the enforcement. Agar log dil se us policy ko accept karke adopt karenge, to ye long term basis pe sustainable hogi. ये ज्यादा एफिशिएंट और इफेक्टिव लेवल पे आपके डिजायर्ड रिजल्ट्स अचीव करेगी. लेकिन अगर आप इसे डंडे के जोर पे इम्प्लीमेंट करेंगे या एनफोर्स करेंगे, तो इट वुड नॉट ओनली स्टे अ शॉर्ट रन ओरिएंटेड अप्रोच, रादर इट वुड बी वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट फिनोमिना to earn your desired objective on the basis of the enforcement. Now, how about the strategic visibility from the module 4 point of view as far as enforcement and monitoring and evaluation is concerned? Strategic visibility is all about enforcement efforts aimed at business practices and not on youth. Then visibility is one major key to compliance from this perspective. Dear students, this enforcement continuum begins actually with education, such as merchant education. It always emphasizes public safety through prevention. ये जो prevention वाला aspect है, dear students, ये बहुत अहम है. पब्लिक पॉलिसी चाहे वो हेल्थ मॉडल के लिए है, चाहे वो एजुकेशन या एनवायरनमेंट से रिलेटेड है, इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसी से रिलेटेड है, कुछ जुडिशियल रूल्स रेगुलेशन बाय लॉज की फॉर्मुलेशन से रिलेटेड है, ये किसी प्रॉब्लम को किसी इशू को फोकस करती है। और प्रॉब्लम पर्टिकुलरली हेल्थ के प्रॉब्लम में एनवायरनमेंट पोल्यूशन की पॉलिसी मेकिंग के हवाले में प्रिवेंशन इज ऑलवेज बी द बेस्ट स्ट्रेटेजी। So, dear students, this must be compliance without errors if possible. Now, if we go about tracking and monitoring, as far as this particular aspect of the module 4 of enforcement, monitoring, evaluation is concerned, it would have been letting you know about some different monitoring techniques. Then developing partnerships, then working through unintended consequences even. Dear students, our next step would be related to taking tangible actions, would be related to taking probable challenges and overcoming different challenges as far as your public health policy model is concerned. So what will you do when you get back home? This is the aspect, this is the question which you have to ask yourself after once you have addressed all four aspects of your this public policy, particularly from the health model point of view, in which we have discussed four modules. To me, the module of adoption, which was the third module, and the module 4, which is about the enforcement, which is about the monitoring, and which is about the evaluation, these two modules are going to be the application side of your policy. And these two modules are very, very important if you really would like to earn some fruitful results, some benefits which you actually sought before the formulation of that policy. You can take it up as the intentions of government actions, but at operational level. ऐसी कोई भी पॉलिसी डियर स्टूडेंट्स जिसकी अडॉप्शन में और जिसको आपको एनफोर्स करने में या जिसकी सस्टेनेबिलिटी डेवलप करने में आपको एज अ पॉलिटिकल एक्टर सीरियस इश्यू हो, वो पॉलिसी सिर्फ रद्दी की टोकरी के लिए तो शायद अहम हो सकती है, वो किसी भी कम्युनिटी वेलबींग के लिए, कम्युनिटी साइकिल में, कम्युनिटी व्हील में जो हमने जिन जिन स्टेक होल्डर्स को एड्रेस किया था उनमें से वो किसी को कुछ भी बेनिफिट नहीं देती। जो एक पॉलिसी का सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट होता है डियर स्टूडेंट्स, चाहे वो एनवायरनमेंट की पॉलिसी है, चाहे हेल्थ रिलेटेड पॉलिसी है, चाहे एजुकेशन से रिलेटेड पॉलिसी है, चाहे आपकी इकोनॉमिक और फिस्कल पॉलिसीज हैं, इसके सबसे बड़े कंज्यूमर, इसका सबसे बड़ा बेनिफिट कम्युनिटी साइकिल में और कम्युनिटी व्हील में जो रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स दिए गए हैं उनको इसका बेनिफिट मिलना चाहिए। आपको जिस तरह मैंने एक्सप्लेन किया था मॉड्यूल 3 और मॉड्यूल 4 से पहले ऑफ दिस पब्लिक पॉलिसी हेल्थ मॉडल के जनाब कम्युनिटी व्हील के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से, कम्युनिटी व्हील में स्कूल्स भी हैं जिनमें एजुकेशन अर्न करने वाले यानी कि स्टूडेंट्स भी हैं और एजुकेशन डिलीवर करने वाले यानी कि टीचर्स भी हैं और स्पोर्ट स्टाफ भी है और टीचर्स के अलावा और लोग जो इसमें स्टेक होल्डर्स के तौर पे जिनका इंटरेस्ट डेवलप हो जाता है वो उन स्टूडेंट्स के पेरेंट्स हैं जो अपने स्टूडेंट्स को एजुकेशन प्रोवाइड करना चाहते हैं। आपकी पॉलिसी चाहे प्रिवेंशन को फोकस कर रही है, चाहे एप्लीकेशन या एडॉप्शन को फोकस कर रही है, किसी भी पर्टिकुलर एस्पेक्ट में, वो सिर्फ उसी वक्त मीनिंगफुल है जब आप शाम को घर आते हैं तो आप अपने आप से ये क्वेश्चन करते हैं, व्हाट विल यू डू व्हेन यू गेट बैक होम, कि मैंने आज का काम मुकम्मल कर लिया है। कम्युनिटी व्हील में जो हमने स्टूडेंट्स की बात की, उनके तमाम कंसर्न्स रिगार्डिंग दी अर्निंग ऑफ हायर क्वालिटी एजुकेशन सर्व हो गए हैं, जो उनको एजुकेशन प्रोवाइड करने वाले हैं, जो कि एजुकेटर्स हैं या टीचर्स हैं, उनको अच्छी पे मिल रही है, उनको अच्छा वर्किंग एनवायरमेंट मिल रहा है। इसके साथ साथ डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आपको याद होगा कि प्रीवियस स्लाइड में जब हम कम्युनिटी व्हील में स्टूडेंट्स को या स्कूल्स को डिस्कस किया था, तो उसके साथ ही नेक्स्ट जो हमारा इंपॉर्टेंट रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ कम्युनिटी व्हील है वो सीनियर सिटीजन्स है। किसी भी सोसाइटी में, किसी भी माशरे में सबसे ज्यादा जो हक होता है वो सीनियर सिटीजन का होता है, सोशल ग्राउंड्स पे, मॉरल ग्राउंड्स पे, इवन एथिकल और लीगल ग्राउंड्स पे भी सीनियर सिटीजन्स का राइट, उनकी टेक केयर सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट होती है। सो आपकी पब्लिक हेल्थ मॉडल के हवाले से सीनियर सिटीजन की पर्टिकुलर नीड्स, उनके पर्टिकुलर इश्यूज को सामने रखते हुए अगर आप अपनी पॉलिसी ऑफ हेल्थ इस तरह की डिजाइन करेंगे कि जो इसमें सीनियर सिटीजन्स हैं उनके लिए आपने कॉस्ट के पर्सपेक्टिव से फ्री मेडिकेशन अलाउ कर दी है, उनके लिए इंतहाई एडवांस और सोफिस्टिकेटेड मेडिकेशन को उनके डोर स्टेप पे इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ वेरी गुड हॉस्पिटल्स एंड मेडिकेशन सेंटर्स आपने एंश्योर कर दिया है कि दीज ऑल आर डेफिनेटली अवेलेबल। इट विल बी एक्चुअली अ बिग सर्विस टू दी एक्चुअल कंज्यूमर्स ऑफ योर पब्लिक पॉलिसी एज द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ योर कम्युनिटी। इसी तरह डियर स्टूडेंट्स, जो यूथ होता है, यूथ का जो सेगमेंट है किसी भी कम्युनिटी में, दिस पर्टिकुलर सेगमेंट यूज टू टॉक अबाउट द फ्यूचर एंड टूमोरो ऑफ दैट कम्युनिटी। आपने यूथ के हवाले से पब्लिक हेल्थ मॉडल में उनकी बाकी जरूरियात के हवाले से अपनी पॉलिसी के अंदर सीरियस कंसर्न शो करना कि यूथ को कौन कौन से एस्पेक्ट और किन किन ग्राउंड्स पे आप अपने हेल्थ मॉडल की पॉलिसी के हवाले से फैसिलिटेट करेंगे, उनके लिए एजुकेशनल पॉलिसी कैसे आप डिजाइन करेंगे, उनके लिए प्ले ग्राउंड्स आप कैसे अरेंज करेंगे। पॉलिसी पर्सपेक्टिव में जब आपका डिसीजन का पर्सपेक्टिव आ जाता है, विच इज अगेन वन वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द स्टडी ऑफ पब्लिक पॉलिसी, यूथ से रिलेटेड जितने डिसीजंस हैं, दे वुड हैव बीन एक्चुअली डिवेलपिंग द स्ट्रॉन्ग फाउंडेशन ऑफ दैट कम्युनिटी एज फार एज द रिक्वायरमेंट्स और द नीड्स ऑफ टूमोरो और द फ्यूचर इज कंसर्न। इसी तरह डियर स्टूडेंट्स, कम्युनिटी व्हील में आपने एक और इंतहाई इम्पॉर्टेंट स्टेक होल्डर्स को मीडिया और बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की फॉर्म में पढ़ा। अगर हम पहले बिजनेस पे थोड़ी सी बात कर लें, एज द मेजर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ वन कम्युनिटी, आपने जितने भी डिफरेंट बिजनेस रन करने वाले रिप्रेजेंटेटिव हैं, जितने भी डिफरेंट इंडस्ट्री में डिफरेंट बिजनेसेस हो रही हैं, उनके हवाले से आपने बिजनेस फ्रेंडली ना खाली एनवायरमेंट क्रिएट करना है एट पब्लिक पॉलिसी लेवल, आपने बिजनेस फ्रेंडली पॉलिसीज डिवेलप करनी है। जिस तरह आपको शायद याद होगा कि कुछ साल पेशतर पाकिस्तान में गवर्नमेंट रिप्रेजेंटेशन के तौर पे एक पब्लिक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन द नेम ऑफ एक्सपोर्ट प्रमोशन ब्यूरो एग्जिस्ट करती थी। अब उसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का नाम एक्सपोर्ट प्रमोशन ब्यूरो से चेंज करके ट्रेड डेवलपमेंट अथॉरिटी रख दी है, एक्सपोर्ट प्रमोशन ब्यूरो में सिर्फ एक्सपोर्ट से रिलेटेड बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस को फैसिलिटेट किया जाता था, बट द मोमेंट दे हैव चेंज द टाइटल ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड कन्वर्ट इट टू द ट्रेड डेवलपमेंट अथॉरिटी, ट्रेडिंग में ना खाली आपकी एक्सपोर्ट्स आ जाती हैं, इसके अलावा जो अदर फॉर्म्स ऑफ बिजनेसेस है विच आर नॉट इसेंशियली एक्सपोर्टेशन रिलेटेड, दैट पर्टिकुलर गवर्नमेंट रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ट्रेड डेवलपमेंट अथॉरिटी इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू फॉर्मुलेट बिजनेस फ्रेंडली पॉलिसी फॉर द बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड फॉर द कंज्यूमर्स ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ दोज बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन टू हेल्प दोज बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जेनरेट मोर रेवेन्यू फॉर देयर कंट्री, टू अट्रैक्ट द फॉरेन इन्वेस्टर्स, टू डिवेलप सम सच टाइप ऑफ बिजनेस एनवायरमेंट इन विच ड्यू टू दैट पब्लिक पॉलिसी परस्पेक्टिव नॉट ओनली लोकल इन्वेस्टर वुड हैव बीन इन्वेस्टिंग इन टू द न्यू एवेन्यूज ऑफ बिजनेस, द फॉरेन इन्वेस्टर वुड ऑल्सो बी फीलिंग हाईली मोटिवेटेड एंड अट्रैक्टेड टू कम अप विद दिस फॉरेन इन्वेस्टमेंट इन योर कम्युनिटीज. एंड अलॉन्ग विद दैट डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज फार एज द development of a peaceful environment, a respectful environment is concerned, a sportive and a competitive environment even concerned, the role of media is somehow very strategic, and this media is again a community's representative at a very strong level. कम्युनिटी पे जो मीडिया पे जो कम्युनिटी के रेफरेंस ग्रुप के लोग होते हैं, दे यूज टू अपीयर टू टॉक अबाउट डिफरेंट पॉलिटिकल, सोशल, फैमिली ओरिएंटेड इश्यूज, एंड दे वुड हैव बीन प्रोवाइडिंग विद देयर विजडम टू द कम्युनिटी थ्रू द इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ मीडिया. Another very, very important aspect as far as the contribution of media as one very strong player of the community is concerned, it always provides the member of the community and even to those people who are heading the position of policy makers with the updated, latest and enough and adequate amount of information. It is very important from both aspects. For policy makers, this information which they would have been receiving through media will be helping them to develop a clear knowledge, awareness of the actual issues and the problems of community. And on the other side, public, common public, the community representative would have been finding the representation of community into the consultation, into having a talk of the community representative with the policy maker to actually make the policy maker feel the real involvement of the indigenous aspects of the indigenous problems of that community. So whether from among the community cycle or from among this community wheel, the role of schools is concerned, or the role of senior citizens is concerned, or the role of even youth is concerned, or the role of another very strong player of the community wheel in the form of business organizations is concerned, and even the role of media into the development of social norms and the behaviors and the consumption patterns and the preferences and the liking and the disliking of the community is concerned, and all these things will ultimately be playing their very, very important and vital role into the decision of policy makers as far as the formulation and implementation of the policy for some certain region on some certain issue is concerned. And from that point of view, let me remind you this aspect, that in our today's case study, what we have discussed about public health model, we have advocated एंड डिवोटेड, वेरी एग्रेसिव एंड सिंसियर सपोर्ट टू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ प्रिवेंशन. Prevention is always better than the cure. If you would have been as a political actor or the government representative, for example in Pakistan, Ministry of Health is the government representative which has to get involved into this health model policy. And if they would have been bringing all these aspects into their very honest and serious consideration, they would also be have been imposing some such bans on smoking like activities and on all those particular aspect and products consumption which are dangerous and injurious to the health of the community people, which must not be sold to somebody who is less than the age of 18. As even in Pakistan, Ministry of Health has banned, and to this public policy government has shown the complete support that nobody could sell tobacco products to somebody who is less than the age of 18. Such bans on the consumption of hazardous products, those products which are not good for the health, would be definitely playing its vital role into the public health policy related issues. And then finally, I would have been suggesting you the importance of module 3 and module 4, which we have discussed in our today's lecture. Module 3 was all about the adoption of policy, the acceptance and policy, the application of the policy. And after once you have adopted one policy, whether it is related to the judicial perspective or the administrative perspective or even to the education perspective, after the adoption of that policy, this perspective would be very, very important as far as then in module 4, the confirmation of the reinforcement, the confirmation of the monitoring and the evaluation of that something is concerned. So, dear student, this was our today's lecture. मुझे उम्मीद है कि इसमें जो मॉड्यूल 3 और मॉड्यूल 4 है, ये आपकी अपनी ज़ाती ज़िंदगी के हवाले से भी इंडिविजुअल लेवल पे बहुत अहम है. आपकी अपनी ज़ात के लिए जो भी आपने अपने आप को पॉलिसी गाइडलाइंस देते हुए पॉलिसी डिसीजंस किए हुए हैं, डियर स्टूडेंट्स, बहुत अहम है कि आप उनको अडॉप्ट करके अपनी डेली प्रैक्टिसेस में उनकी प्रेजेंस को बहुत सिग्निफिकेंट रखें और उसकी कंटिन्यूटी में अपने ऊपर उसे एनफोर्स करते रहें. एंड इफ यू वुड हैव बीन टेकिंग दिस टू एस्पेक्ट्स इन योर पर्सनल लाइफ ऑफ द अडॉप्शन एंड मॉनिटरिंग ऑफ योर ओन पॉलिसीज, इट विल डेफिनेटली बी वेरी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू फॉर द अचीवमेंट ऑफ योर एनी टारगेट विच वुड बी एड्रेस्ड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट. आई विश यू ऑल वेरी वेरी गुड लक. अपना बहुत सारा ख्याल रखें, मुझे भी अपनी दुआ में हमेशा याद रखें. इंशाल्लाह नेक्स्ट लेक्चर के लिए मुलाकात करेंगे. तब तक खुदा आपका हामी व नासिर हो. अल्लाह हाफिज़.